At it, McKee ghosting across, has the footy, has a problem, kicks it out of bounds, deliberate.
I'm going to have to sign too. Doom, I reckon, if they're not in panic mode, they are feeling some pressure at the moment.
Bannister to Herd, offers to Ben, sends it back, puts it through.
I mean, the kid knows his limitations, and he knows it.
Kid knows his captain.
James has no limitations. Go sideways, it's as simple as that.
Straight to the bench, that's your reward for giving the skipper one. But,
do you reckon James sent him there?
No, I reckon they're going to get another mismatch pretty shortly. They brought a Hill back onto the ground. And gee, for a side, when we went into this game, you thought that the strength play in the Collingwood forwards, 7-2 marked inside 50 Essendon's way, and that's purely because they got options everywhere.
Collingwood are going with 8 backmen now, Essendon are manning them up. The kid who's
closing in on three-quarter time. Tough angle. Kicks with the right. Brings it across the face. Chance for the mark. They fly. Off hands up free, but he dropped it. Got the kick away just in time. Lucuria with 4 to beat. Herd inside 50. The General!
Gary, talk about this in a second. When you see the replay, the composure of James Herd, he looks down at the ball to actually see which side the laces are. He looks down at it to work out where the laces are and lays it on his boot. Watch him look down at it here. There you go. He recognises I'm kicking the right side. Little things like that. The really good players don't even have to, you know, feel pressured for time, but that's amazing.
You don't see James Herd get excited like that too often either, which tells you about the stakes on offer here today.
I think we've got to say that as position, hey, Buckley in the second. 30 minutes remaining, and we expect they'll play out like there's no tomorrow. Alessio rolls it towards half forward, Lloyd on hands and knees to Barnard. Ball trickles inside 50 to Herd. Don't tell me!
He kicks that.
Unbelievable!
One.
He's got three.
He kicked that. He put his nose over the ball, which is the most dangerous place to do in a pack for your own safety, because you can't see what's going on around. You have to rely on the trust of your teammates. And he kicked that before he actually comes upright. You watch him. He just hunches over it. He's such. I mean, people talk about how brave he is. This is a pure example here. Look, down. And he's kicked that before he straightened up.
He's a star, Doom. He's an absolute star. Every time they've been threatened, I reckon he's the one that's just said, rightio, that's enough, let's get back on track. Two wonderful players, opposing captains. 3 goals to Herd is critical.
Alessio to do the ruck work against McKee. Inside 50. Ball thump clear, but to Macedi. Bumps. Gives it to James Herd. Screws it around the body. There is none better. He's got 4.
Who was riding the man off? Herd. You wouldn't dare, would you? You would not be so foolish as to suggest he's gone. If you have a look at today's performance, it's just a star.
Do you count that as a disposal to Jonas Eagle?
You give it to Joe because he needs it at the moment and work back into it pretty well.
Collingwood have been setting up in this final quarter with at least 7 backmen.
122-73. Seems it's over. Behind the pack. Can he do it again, James Herd? I think he may have.
That's a big one.
He's kicked 5. How's that for an encore?
The best of them. That was an extreme goal. Well, he won the 2000, year 2000 Anzac medal here on Anzac Day. And, well, Buckley would be his competition. But I tell you what, it's going to come from one of the captains, that's for sure.
And what a hero, James Herd. Just making the point, he was off the ground. you'd still like him to win the Anzac medal and I guess get the three Brownlow boys. It becomes something of an interesting debatable topic as we go down to Anthony Mifflin with James, that man.
James Heard, yes, you enjoyed that one, James.
Yeah, no, look, we've been under the pump, people have written us off and it's just great. We love Anzac Day and it's great to win.
You're pretty emotional too, kicking a few of those goals at Shielded.
Yeah, look, it's just a big game, you know, it's been a while since we've won one of these and we'll savour it, and it's been a good win.
It's a good for you personally too, because you have had your 30th birthday, and some people want to say that's enough for you.
Yeah, look, hopefully there's a couple of good games left, and we'll see how it goes.
It was a terrific team effort though, wasn't it? There was hardly a spot lost on the ground for the Bombers' point of view.
Yeah, look, the boys are great, from Lloydie right the way back to Jimmy Jacobs, everyone put in, and you know, this can hopefully kickstart our season.
I reckon they might have a medal for you, so we'll let you go, we'll see what happens. Good on you, Jimmy.
Good on you.
Anthony Mifflin.